What follows is a brief outline of my book, Wisdomkeepers of Stonehenge. Built before the pyramids of Egypt, Stonehenge is one of the most enigmatic monuments on Earth. Even today, no one knows why it was built. It may be the most impressive monument of its kind, and the only one with arches, but it is only one of thousands of stone circles erected throughout the British Isles for centuries, beginning around 3100 BC. They vary in size. Some are small, but many are truly massive. Those who built them, the megalithic culture, lived in modest settlements and used simple prehistoric tools. Such constructions would have taken vast resources and work hours to create. Unique to the British Isles, stone circles must have been of immense importance to those who erected them. Yet, until the arrival of the Romans in the mid-first century BC, the people of the British Isles lived a modest lifestyle and had no form of writing to reveal why these monuments were built. Throughout the megalithic era, successive groups of migrants settled in the British Isles from continental Europe, each from very different cultures. Yet the archaeological evidence shows that these newcomers all joined in with the building and use of stone circles. This suggests that these ancient rings of monoliths must surely have had some practical rather than religious function. During the 20th century, archaeologists determined that, when viewed from the centre of the ring, Stonehenge and other stone circles had megaliths aligned to the sunrise and sunset at specific times of the year, such as the midsummer and midwinter solstice. But more recent research has revealed that stones also aligned to the rising and setting of particularly bright stars at specific times of the year, and to the phases of the moon. It is thought that such observations would allow the megalithic people to determine the exact times to sow, tend, and harvest crops. However, general crop cultivation could be achieved by observing the stars, the moon, and other heavenly bodies without the need for such elaborate monuments. If they were astronomical calculators, stone circles must have been built to enable some very precise calculations indeed. So, who was using them? From the archaeological evidence, it seems that they were those whose remains have been found in a distinctive type of burial structure known as a box tomb, because they are always found nearby or adjacent to stone circles. Intriguingly, these revered individuals appear to have been healers. Scientific analysis of the contents of pots found in the tombs has revealed that they contained substances extracted from plants used for ancient pharmaceutical purposes, such as for their analgesic, antiseptic, and curative properties. In order to extract such substances from vegetation, precise timing would be crucial, because the chemical constituents of the different parts of plants to be harvested vary not only throughout the course of the year, but often at particular times of the day or night. For instance, some flowers release particular chemicals at very specific times of the night, according to the position of the moon, and on just a few days of the year to attract pollinating moths. The preparation of such ancient medicines is the primary purpose, I believe, for which stone circles as precise astronomical calculators were used. The latest archaeological methods of dating ancient monuments has now shown that box tombs and stone circles continued to be used for much longer than once thought, for an astonishing 3,000 years, until the Romans invaded Britain in the 1st century AD. And it is from this period that we do have written records concerning those who used the stone circles, the occupants of the box tombs. The Romans called them the Druids. Today, Druids perform ceremonies at Stonehenge. However, modern Druidism only dates from the 19th century and has no historical link to the practices of those recorded by the Romans. It was once thought that the Druids of the Roman period were a distinctly Celtic priesthood who used pre-existing stone circles for their own purposes, having had no connection to the people who originally used them. But the new dating of box tomb burials now implies that the 1st century Druids were the direct successors of the earlier stone circle builders. What the Romans tell us of the Druids confirms what archaeology has revealed from the medicines found in their tombs, that they were accomplished physicians. They had preparations for pain relief, cures for parasites, decongestants, remedies for the control of fever, antiseptics, disinfectants, antidotes for various poisons, and much more besides. Furthermore, we learn that the Druids did indeed collect botanical extracts at very specific times, determined by the positions of the heavenly bodies, such as the moon and stars, just as I propose was made possible by the use of stone circles. Incredibly, the Roman naturalist Pliny the Elder, writing around 60 AD, suggests that the Druids may even have found a cure for cancer derived from mistletoe. Scientists have recently extracted a compound from that very plant used in modern chemotherapy. We can only guess at what cures the megalithic people possessed. Sadly, their secrets died with them. Perhaps, though, at last we can make an informed guess as to the purpose of Stonehenge. It may have been an ancient healthcare facility.